The food system is the greatest cause of greenhouse emission, biodiversity loss, ecosystem destruction, and freshwater pollution in the world. In Canada, the situation is worrying. Not only we have 58% of food waste, we also have food-related diseases. As a matter of fact, the food system is a system of great extremes and paradoxes. Famine versus obesity, high production versus food waste, and promotion of healthy habits versus subsidies on environmentally damaging farming practices. My name is Geneviève Clément, and I'm a microbiologist and master student in the agri-food sector at the University of Sherbrooke. As a scientist, I'm deeply concerned where we are asked to find new techniques when millennial, sustainable, and scientifically proven method works but are not applied. When a bad habit causes a disease, giving a pill might fix the symptoms, but fixing the lifestyle will fix the problem once and for all. We can do better, can't we? Then, why is it so difficult? To answer this question, I choose to investigate my hometown, Granby, which is situated near Montreal in Canada. Granby offers a wide range of opportunities because of its small size, young population, dynamic, varied density areas, services offered, economic diversity, in addition to its urban growth and configuration. There, I found human-scale solutions applicable rapidly. One of my findings is partnerships. It's exciting because almost no governmental action is needed, and it may include multiple actors, big and small, in the system. This makes the solution much more feasible. Let me explain where this solution came from. Farming is our job financially, mentally, and physically. Facilitating and offering partnerships opportunities is a way to offer financial security and social security to sustainable farmers. Partnerships offer benefits for every participant. It can be between farmers, consumers, business, schools. Partnerships can help enhance accessibility to sustainably made products, and it can be a possibility for educational programs. It may be a great solution for green space valorization through urban farming. In this game, city support could mean a great deal if it modifies zoning laws on industrial and commercial land where safe for farming purposes. All in all, partnerships can bring community spirit and solidarity at a new level. System thinking approach is a great tool for mapping interactions. Still, what I have learned from Map the System is not only the usefulness to map these interactions, but the usefulness to look at these interactions with multiple glasses. Depending to which specialist a problem is given, their approach will be different, as will their answers. As I investigated the work of James Clear and Priya Parker, I learned that solutions need to resonate with people and the way they live. Actions towards sustainability need to be obvious, attractive, satisfying, and easy in order to work. Partnerships mean people we gather together. It will help them connect, understand their realities, have empathy, make better products, etc. It's the most human and effective way to raise awareness and make sustainability satisfying, attractive, and obvious. As I explained in my project, I think that's the true reason why sustainable product promotion fails, and that's the reason why I think partnerships is an exciting solution. When I learned that some sustainable solutions were already known but not used, I must confess I was angry. Angry because I thought farmers were picky or wanted to overstep nature's laws. Of course, I was prejudiced and I was wrong. By getting to know them, I understand that they wanted to be more sustainable, but they didn't have the tools, the knowledge, nor the financial resiliency to do so. They are not the problem. The problem is the system. So, before putting on my lab coat again, I knew I needed to contribute transforming the system. It all starts in our hometown, no matter how small it is. Thank you.